Hi, this is Woojay at LINBIT, and today I'll demonstrate the basics of deploying clustered Linux storage within OpenStack. OpenStack is an open source software for creating private cloud environments. The tools we'll be using are LINBIT's LINSTOR and DRBD software, which are also open source. LINSTOR is an open source storage provisioning and management tool developed by LINBIT. It allows you to create, remove, and manage block storage for Linux. DRBD is a mainline kernel software that replicates data at the block level. Using both technologies, users can provision replicated, highly available block storage to enable an OS-based software-defined storage. In this demo, we'll be showing how LINSTOR can create an OpenStack volume, then take a snapshot to easily create a duplicate volume. So I have a DevStack version of OpenStack running one Nova compute instance called USS LINSTOR. Underneath OpenStack, I have a two-node LINSTOR cluster. Node LG is the node OpenStack is running on, and it is defined as a diskless controller node for LINSTOR. Inside LINSTOR, diskless nodes are nodes without storage, so LG does not contain any storage. However, the node 1 is satellite node with LVM storage. This setup allows an OpenStack node to control an entire LINSTOR cluster without having to manage any local storage, while delegating diskful satellite nodes to manage actual data. If a LINSTOR cluster contains more than one diskful node, the data is seamlessly replicated among all the diskful nodes. We can use a command line or this Horizon GUI to create a LINSTOR volume. First, we select and give it a name, and pick LINSTOR as the volume type. While the volume is being created, the LINSTOR driver for OpenStack creates underlying resource and volume definitions and creates actual storage resources on diskful nodes, in this case on node 1. On the back end, our volume for OpenStack are synonymous with LINSTOR resources. When we list our LINSTOR resource, we can see that one resource with the name given by OpenStack is deployed on both nodes, and while node LG controls cluster, only node 1 maintains actual data in this case. We can then attach this new volume into our compute instance USS LINSTOR. Once the volume is attached, it will show up within the instance as a device /dev/vdb. I can then format this device and mount it wherever we want. Once mounted, we'll create a test file in the new volume. For the sake of the demonstration, I will quickly unmount the newly created volume and we'll return to the Horizon GUI. And from there, we'll detach it from the running instance. Once a volume is safely detached, we can then take a snapshot of that volume. Snapshots are available in both LVM and ZFS volumes and are defined as a copy of a volume at a specific point in time. Once a snapshot is taken, a separate volume can then be created in OpenStack based on this snapshot, and this will create another LINSTOR resource in return with the previous data from the snapshot. This pretty much works like restoring a backup to a new volume. From the terminal, we can list the new LINSTOR resource as well as the old one. And we can indeed see that there are two different resources deployed on both nodes. The newly created volume can then be attached to our compute instance just like before, and we'll attach it to the USS LINSTOR one more time. Once this volume is attached, we can access it just as before. In the same console as before, the new volume will take the same DEV/VDB location as the system reuses available device locations. But since the original snapshot contained a formatted volume with data, instead of formatting and mounting, we'll simply mount the volume to a new location. And as expected, we can see previously created test files present in the newly duplicated volume. We again unmount this volume and detach that volume as well. To properly remove or delete a volume, we must first delete any snapshots associated with their parent volume. So in this case, we delete the one snapshot that we created. And then we can delete both of the volumes that we created as well. When we list the LINSTOR resources one last time, we can see that all the LINSTOR resources have been removed. This concludes the demonstration. In this video, we used the LINSTOR to manage block storage snapshots for OpenStack. Though we did not cover data replication in this video, data replication is also easily achieved by changing the diskless node to a regular diskful node with storage, and using DRBD to replicate the data in between. For any questions regarding LINSTOR driver for OpenStack, DRBD, or other LINBIT technology, please visit www.linbit.com or follow the links in the comments. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe.